Blending modes are a set of mathematical equations that allow you to blend layers by utilizing their hue, saturation, luminosity, or a combination of those components. They all work pretty much the same, but eight of those blending modes have two special features that separate them from the rest. In this video, I'm going to show you what those differences are and how you can take advantage of them for your creative projects. In this project, I have a background layer and a blank layer. I'll select the blank layer and I'll click on the drop down here. The eight blending modes that stand out from the rest are color burn, linear burn, color dodge, linear dodge add, vivid light, linear light, hard mix, and difference. These blending modes have two extra properties that the others do not have. For this example, I'll select color dodge, but everything that I discuss about color dodge will also apply to the other seven remaining blending modes. With the brush tool selected and white as my foreground color, I'm going to paint over the image. The biggest difference between these eight blending modes and the rest is that opacity and fill give you different results. With all the other blending modes, the result is the same. Notice the difference. If I bring down the opacity, you can see that the white becomes duller. But when I bring down the fill, that the colors blend much better. In my opinion, with these eight blending modes, reducing fill as opposed to opacity gives you better results. And the second big difference is that you can uncheck a box to blend the pixels even better. With the layer selected, you can either double click to the side of the layer, or if you prefer, go into the FX icon and select blending options. From the layer style panel, under advanced blending, you can simply uncheck the transparency shapes layer box so you can see the difference. See how the outer pixels blend differently with the layer below by unchecking this box? I'll press OK. And I can reduce the fill. And this is a technique that you can use to create a specular highlight on your image. With the move tool selected, I can just move this highlight anywhere I want on my photo to create that effect that you see there. Something that you can do is, with the background layer selected, go into Select, Subject, to let Photoshop's Adobe Sensei, the artificial intelligence, detect the main subject, create a selection around it, and then I can create a layer mask around this layer. Then I can select the layer thumbnail and with white, paint over the image to enhance the highlights, like so. And obviously I'm going very quickly here, but I think that you get the idea. I encourage you to experiment with the remaining seven blending modes to see what type of cool effects you can create. If you want to learn more about blending modes, then make sure you check out this video. I go through all the blending modes, I explain what they do and how they work. Make sure that you check it out now.